Good day. This is Peter Knipp from Castlestone Management with comments on the U.S. equity market for February 1st. The spread of the coronavirus within China and the reporting of additional cases outside of China sparked a global sell-off in stocks, resulting in the worst week for U.S. equity markets since August. All told, the Dow dropped 733.70 points, or 2.53%, to 28,256.03. While the S&P 500 fell 2.1% to 3,225.52, and the NASDAQ composite slid 1.8% to 9,150.94. Only two sectors, utilities up 0.8% and consumer discretionary up 0.1%, finished the week higher. The uncertainty surrounding the impact of the deadly virus will have on the expected global economic rebound remains unclear. There are some things investors should consider. The equity market pullback lowered the number of S&P 500 stocks trading above their 50-day moving average from 80% on January 17th to 45% on Friday. Finally, earnings are holding up. Two-thirds of the S&P 500 index companies that have reported have beat on the earnings line. U.S. Treasuries yields fell as investors shifted away from stocks into the safety of bonds. The 10-year Treasury yield dipped 5.9 basis points this week. The 2-year note yield slipped 15.1 basis points, and the 30-year bond rate fell 11.6 basis points. The safe haven currencies like the yen and the Swiss franc both rallied to 2- and 3-week highs versus the U.S. dollar last week. Benefiting from the flight to safety, gold ended the week up 0.6% at $1,587.90 an ounce, its highest weekly close since March of 2019. The economic impact of the coronavirus on the global economic recovery hit oil markets last week as well. WTI logged a 4.9% weekly fall, and Brent crude lost 4.2%. Thank you for listening, and thank you for doing business with Castlestone, and let's keep those affected by the virus in our thoughts.